I recognize the man of God.
Amen.
And I do believe God is going to use him to talk to me and talk to you.
Amen.
And at the end, you will say, praise the Lord.
Amen.
And to God be the glory.
Amen.
It is a privilege to have you with me. And have the right and let the Holy Spirit guide you and say what he asked you to say. May God bless you.
Praise the Lord. Greetings from the Potter's House Church of God in Mystic, Connecticut. I'm bringing greetings from Bishop Spada. Glad to be traveling this morning with my wife Melissa and my son Seth, and they're here joining me this morning. Thank you, Pastor Jacques, for a gracious invitation to come and share this service with you this morning. And as I was seeking the Lord on what to speak this morning, I was having a conversation with another pastor yesterday over Facebook, and as we were talking, I believe the Lord dropped a message in my heart, so I have some fresh bread for you this morning.
Amen.
The Bible says that out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks. You know, God is always looking at what's in our heart, amen? You know, God doesn't look at us the way man looks at us. He doesn't judge things the way man judges things. And I think of for decades now that the American Christians have been being taught and being influenced by the world. The Bible says don't be conformed to the image of this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your minds. But how many knows that as God has an agenda to change us and make us more and more like Jesus, that the enemy also has his own agenda.
Amen.
To try to make us and conform us into the image of this world.
I'm going to trust a little bit for some of you.
Sure.
Les dit que bon Dieu va garder nous même gens l'homme garder nous. Nous même nous garder sous peau, mais bon Dieu garder dans cœur. Nous devons vivre comme chrétiens, nous devons transformer. Nous avons vécu dans le monde, mais nous ne sommes pas partis du monde. Nous partis pour nos essences, monde poussière. Mais.
I think of even as my own life, I'm 57 years old, but I hadn't served God my whole life. I did not grow up in a Christian family. And for 29 years, I lived the way that a worldly person lives.
Il y a des gens qui ne sont pas faits dans l'église. Malgré qu'il ait 50 ans, il y a 22 ans qu'il a servi mon Dieu. Il fait le choix pour vivre, c'est nous la parole que mon Dieu veut pour vivre.
I learned the ways of the world, the way the world thinks, the way the world operates, and the goals and the pursuits and the ambitions and plans of the world. That's what my heart was going after for 29 years.
Il dit pour 29 ans de vivre, il a accepté mon Dieu à 29 ans avec 22 ans d'âge. Il y a 57 ans, l'idée de vivre, Jean Monsa de vivre, il y a une ambition, même Jean Monsa, tout le monde a besoin, tout le monde a besoin, tout le monde a vivre, c'est comme ça qu'il est vivre. Il y a besoin de vivre, il y a besoin de s'ambition, besoin de tissu, besoin d'être. C'est Jean de vivre ça, il y a besoin de vivre, de crédit, besoin de tout pour eux, c'est Jean de vivre ça, il y a besoin de vivre. Mais il vit pour Jésus, il vit dans l'autre vie.
As a young person, I learned to lie, cheat, and steal, and do the things it takes to make easy money. While other people were out working hard to earn a living, I thought that, you know, the people that worked were foolish, and I was too smart to work. That's the mentality I had as a person growing up in the world with worldly influences, and people in my family were doing things that they should not be doing, and I learned the ways of the world, and I learned money without
mette fok tout bagay ke l'pata dwe fè, jan wè fòmè la viv, jan lè vi sa ke l'tap menè, vi an vi vive, mette fok tout sa ki pa bon, lè l'tap viv nan moun sa, se te bagay sa ou de bezwen. Mette fok lè l'tap tout ak malounè l'pata dwe fè, mette fok lè l'tap viv nan moun sa.
People have a slogan in the world that he that dies with the most toys wins the game. And that's what Hollywood is perpetrating. That's what the books are perpetrating. That's what worldly men and worldly influences are perpetrating. It's even infiltrated into many church people's lives. They're hearing this type of a message that comes through from many church congregations being preached this morning, that he that has the most toys wins the game. In other words, we can have our best life now. If we can just have enough faith, then we can have a big bank account, that we can have the finest house, that we can have the finest cars, that we can have the biggest 401k, that if we can just get enough money, then we've arrived to a certain place. This is what they teach.
Yeah, I need someone to teach you how to get in Hollywood. Se ki moun ki gen pi bel machin, ki moun ki gen pi bel kay, ki moun ki gen pi gol ajan nan bank account yo, ki moun ki gen yon konan program 401k, se bagay sa yo ke moun sa a ofri. Li di menm nan l'eglise ou jwenn jan le moun ki anvi gen moun vi sa yo, yo gen ajan, se jan le vi sa yo. Yo bezwen rive, yo bezwen viv, yo gen yo gridi, yo ka fè tout mouvè ak malonèt, yo ka gen l'ajan. Se jen menm l'eglise ou wè sa anpe, se jen le vi sa ou, se sa moun sa ou fwi, gen menm an de l'eglise ou jen de jan bagay sa ou. Le vi sou l'ajan, moun nan kredi, li remen tout pou li, an yen pou lòk. Yo be sou rive, se sa ou de fè. Menm an de l'eglise ou jen de kalite vi sa ou.
Amen. But Jesus, our master, our savior, the Lord of our lives, he said a man's life doesn't consist of the abundance of his possessions.
Jésus c'est bon, c'est lui même qui bon Dieu, nous c'est lui même qui sauve nous. La vie au monde pas dépend de ça pour posséder, mais il dépend que j'ai des relations que pour garder avec mon Dieu.
Jesus said you can't serve two masters. You'll love one and hate the other.
Il dit ou pas Jésus ou pas qu'à servir deux maîtres à la fois, ou après meilleur, ou après un autre.
You'll hold to one and despise the other. You can't serve God and mammon.
Pas qu'à servir mon Dieu pour servir mon monde à la fois. Il doit servir mon Dieu, il doit servir mon monde. Ça veut dire pas qu'à servir de mettre à la fois, pas qu'à aimer l'argent plus que mon Dieu. C'est qu'il doit servir mon Dieu à son gain ou bien ou griter ou faire acte malhonnête ou qu'à pas priver.
In the same chapter, he says to seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things will be added unto you. That's in Matthew chapter 6.
Chercher présence bon Dieu et tout reste va venir jouer nous comme des guides. Chercher présence bon Dieu avant, chercher bon Dieu avant, reste bagaille à ajouter venir jouer nous comme des guides.
You got your Bibles, turn me to Psalm 73.
Il dit ouvert Bible dans Psalm 73.
In Psalm 73, starting at verse 1, the psalmist says, truly God is good to Israel, even to such of her clean heart. But as for me, my feet were almost gone. My steps were well nigh slipped, for I was envious at the foolish. When I saw the prosperity of the wicked, there were no bands in their death, but their strength is firm. They're not in trouble as other men, neither are they plagued like other men. Therefore, pride compasses them as with a chain. Violence covers them as a garment. Their eyes stand out with fatness. They have more than heart could wish. They're corrupt. They speak wickedly concerning oppression. They speak loftily. They set their mouth against the heavens, and their tongue walks through the earth. Therefore, his people return hither, and waters of a full cup are run out to them. And they say, how does God know? Is there knowledge in the Most High? Behold, these are the ungodly who prosper in the world. They increase in riches. Truly, he says, I've cleansed my heart in vain, and I've washed my hands in innocency. For all day long have I been plagued, and and chastened every morning. And I say, I will speak thus, behold, I should offend against the generation of your children. When I thought to know this, he says, it was too painful for me until I went into the sanctuary of God. Then I understood their end. Surely you did set them in slippery places. You cast them down to destruction. How are they brought into desolation as in a moment? They're utterly consumed with terrors.
Amen.
Amen.
Me feliz que acolo bie nu nu vede din Psalm 73. Psalm 73. Il dit oui, Dieu est bon pour Israël, pour ceux qui ont le cœur pur. Toutefois mon pied allait fléchir, mes pas étaient sur le point de glisser, car je portais envie aux insensés en voyant le bonheur des méchants. Rien ne les tourmente juste jusqu'à leur mort, et leur cœur est chargé d'un bon point. Ils n'ont aucune part aux souffrances humaines, et ils ne sont point frappés comme le reste des hommes. Aussi l'orgueil le sert de collier, la violence et les vêtements qui les enveloppent. L'iniquité sort de leurs entrailles, les pensées de leur cœur se font jour, ils raillent, ils parlent méchamment d'opprimés. Ils profèrent des discours hautains et ils élèvent leur bouche jusqu'au ciel et leurs langues se promènent sur la terre. Voilà, voici son peuple se retourne de leur côté. Ils valent l'eau abondamment et ils disent, comment Dieu saurait-il comme le très haut connaîtrait Comme les très hauts connaîtraient-ils, ainsi sont les méchants toujours errés. Ils accroissent les richesses. C'est donc en vain que je purifie mon cœur. Et je lave mes mains dans l'innocence. Chaque jour, je suis frappé. Tout le matin, mon châtiment est là. Et si je disais, je veux parler comme eux, voici, je trahirais la race de tes enfants. Parole du Seigneur.
Amen. The psalmist, he said in verse 2, he says, but as for me, my feet were almost gone. My steps had well nigh slipped. The psalmist had allowed the influence of the world to influence his understanding and influence his heart. And when he looked out and he saw the trouble that he was in and that Christian people go through, and he saw that how the ungodly, it seemed that they were going through no trouble. They were going through no affliction, and they continued to prosper, and they continued to get gain. He said, you know, my foot, it almost slipped. He said, you know, it was too much for me, he said. When I considered this, when I meditated upon how the ungodly seemed to be getting ahead, and the Christians seemed to be suffering so much, it was overwhelming to the psalmist.
Des fois, il presque perdu la foi que l'éloignement, monde qui pas chrétien, j'ai prospéré. C'est ça, ce qu'on a parlé là. Il était perdu la foi, puis elle demandait qui c'est pour les gens. Parfois, des fois, nous-mêmes qui chrétiens, car c'est un bon Dieu fidèle, pas nous pas marcher. Mais monde qui le monde, qui pas servir bon Dieu, c'est garder où à faire marcher. Mais la somme, non, ça me dit, il était manqué perdu la foi. Il était manqué à aller côté monde ça, qui a fait bagarre qui pas bon. Parfois, monde qui dans le monde, à faire marcher, tout à faire marcher, ou même qu'à faire effort pour servir mon Dieu, le regarder qui est pas toujours bon. Il dit, il était en vie, ça me dit, qui dit ça? Il était en vie, bagaille ça, yo. Chrétien, ou même qui dans mon Dieu, ou garder où est ça, c'est vrai. Parfois, même qu'à servir mon Dieu, à faire pour se, tout à faire pour parler bien, mais mon qui est fidèle, tout seulement est bon pour lui, amen.
Amen.
He said, until I came into the sanctuary of God, and I considered the hereafter. In other words, it's all going to come out in the wash. It's all going to be made right one day. It's not going to continue to be the way it seems like they're getting ahead and you're getting behind. It will all take place one day in its proper time.
Slow down, but when you're like, "Mon Dieu," or less, I'm just like, "Say, let me like, kon bon Dieu li pa pale comme ça pou ouvri yo gon kote pou rive fò pou yo ka sèk yo gen yo tombe nan ou pa mal moun ki pa kon bon Dieu jan ou gen fò la yo passe mal y a fait toute action yo fini mal ou même ki nan bon Dieu gon kote rive pou yo akase.
Jesus taught us to lay not up for yourself treasures here on earth, where moth and rust corrupt and thieves break in and steal. But he says, I tell you to lay up for yourself treasures in heaven, where neither moth nor rust corrupt nor thieves break in and steal. For where your treasure is, there will your heart be also. He says, labor not for the meat which perishes, but that which lasts throughout eternity. I'm talking about true riches this morning. That's the topic that we're discussing this morning. Not the fabricated riches that these Hollywood evangelists teach about. Having big bank accounts and having nice homes and nice cars. Those things are all nice. But that's not what Jesus is all about.
Les bagailles que Jésus a parlé matin, bagailles qu'il parlait matin, c'est pas bagaille terrestre. Les dit pour nous garder dans bagaille céleste, bagaille qui pas détruit. Ou que pas grand gros béga 40, les cap passe un jour, mais les vient parler bagaille matin, c'est pour chercher bagaille en haut, pour chercher bagaille qui pas détruit, bagaille l'homme du feu qui passe ou que dans grand gros caille ou du feu passé, il détruit, mais l'homme chercher bagaille en haut. Les papés, bagaille dit pour chercher bagaille qui impérissable. Chercher bagaille qui pas périr, c'est bagaille ça, c'est richesse ça, il vient pas le matin, c'est pour focus dans mon Dieu, pour chercher trésor, bagaille en haut, bagaille qui pas déçu. Ou que l'on a une machine, ou faut accident, ou perdu machine, ou qu'on a un caille, ou perdu job, ou perdu, bagaille ça va passer, mais qu'on bagaille qui va passer, c'est bagaille en haut qui va passer. C'est bagaille ça, c'est richesse ça, richesse dans Jésus, c'est lui-même qui dit richesse dans Jésus, c'est lui-même qui vient pas le matin, c'est bagaille ça pour chercher.
Bible says in the book of James, hasn't God chosen the poor of this world to be rich in faith and heirs of eternal life?
Lizzy na livre James ou quoi c'est Jacques, Lizzy que l'Éternel bon Dieu, quel monde qui m'a dit que c'est bon Dieu fait vers mon qui pauvre yo na monde ça.
The Bible says that our Savior, the Lord Jesus Christ, was a man of sorrows. He was acquainted with grief. Jesus was not a homeowner. He had no place to lay his head, the Bible teaches. The women of the day ministered to the needs of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Jésus pas de caille, pas de homeowner, mais il est venu pour prêcher avec ça qui pauvre. Il est venu pour prêcher avec mon qui est needs, ni des people, mon qui a besoin. C'est mon ça que Jésus est visé travail ça, Jésus est venu faire. Parfois nous qui chrétiens nous besoin tout pour nous-mêmes. Travail 3 job, 4 job, et nous manquer. Nous manquons dans la vie spirituelle, nous, ni même Jésus pas venu faire bagage ça. C'est pas bagage ça, c'est pas richesse sous des ça. Jésus est venu parler, il est venu focus dans bagage, richesse en bagage en haut, bagage en haut.
This great king, although he was the master and the ruler of the universe, the Bible says he emptied himself, he humbled himself, he took upon himself the form of a servant. Humbled himself, the Bible says.
Il dit Jésus te gagne plus d'humilité comme roi, comme master, comme seul, comme seigneur, comme roi, comme il est venu pour servir, il va venir que pour monter servir. Il est venu, il te gagne plus d'humilité, il est envers l'homme. Il te gagne plus d'humilité, il va venir pour monter servir, mais il est venu pour te servir. Malgré que tu es roi, malgré que tu aies toute autorité, il te gagne. Il va venir pour monter servir, mais il te servir.
Although he was rich, he became poor for our sakes, the scripture says. He was born into a middle-class family. He worked as a carpenter for years with his father, Joseph. Although he was fully man, but he was also fully God. The Bible says, in him dwelleth all the fullness of the Godhead bodily. So he was omniscient. He knew all things. And he picked 12 disciples. And he allowed the one out of the 12, the thief, to carry the money back.
L'Éternel était 100% homme, Jésus était 100% homme, mais il était 100% Dieu. Et il était venu faire mission, il était venu accomplir, il te prend 13 disciples qui te pour faire travail ça. Et mon lit te baye kebe kob, là c'est un yon qui te volé kob, c'est lui même qui te baye kebe beg l'argent pour lui. Vous connaissez des juifs, c'est des juifs là.
Jesus did not see getting ahead the way that many of us see getting ahead. Amen. Allowing the thief to carry the money back. He also had an encounter with a rich young man in Matthew chapter 19 who questioned Jesus on what must I do to have eternal life.
Et il parlait dans Matthieu, il était fait Judas qui avait comme l'argent, il parlait dans Matthieu 19, côté un homme qui était riche, qui dit qui ça pour faire pour garder hériter le royaume.
Jesus told him to keep the commandments.
And
several commandments were listed. And the man says, all these I've kept from my youth. And Jesus said, one thing you do lack. Looking into the very heart of this man. One thing you lack. Jesus didn't analyze things the way that we analyze things. The scripture says the love of money is the root of all evil. I'm not preaching against wealthy people.
That's fine.
But I'm telling you, if your life is consistent of chasing money, if that's what you're meditating upon, prospering in this life, making financial gain, and you're neglecting the things of God. You're working so hard that you don't have time for prayer. You're working so hard you don't have time for Bible study. You don't have time to worship God and fellowship with God's people. Then the world has influenced your heart and you need to repent this morning. Who was making big bucks. Learning from Christ. Watching the miracles. Watching the sick be healed. Watching demons being cast out in his name. And Jesus had just been crucified. And they spent time in the upper room.
I don't get that.
They spent time praying and fasting. Your young men will see visions. And 3,000 people got saved by one sermon.
3,000 moun te konverti le jour de la Pentecôte. Les pieds t'a prêché et t'a prêché l'évangile. Ça te gagne 3,000 moun te repenti.
And about a chapter or so later.
Après chapitre dans passage ça dans Acte chapitre 12.
All Peter's finances had dwindled at this point. The commercial fisherman business wasn't being run by him anymore. But he was
following
fishermen. He was following Christ, and the anointing of the Holy Spirit was resting upon his life. And he was on his way to an old-fashioned prayer meeting. They don't preach that kind of gospel.
Nou ka wè ekzanp pou sa nan Ansyen Testament.
In the New Testament as well.
Ou ka wè ekzanp pou sa nan New Testament.
Of people who had their heart in the wrong place.
Yo te gen kèw nan mouvè kote.
We see in the New Testament Ananias and Sapphira by name.
Ya nou ka wè sa nan Nouvè Testament kote yo mete kèw nan mouvè pozisyon.
Who were Christians but they were deceitful Christians.
Ya gen moun nan Ansyen Testament ke yo te kretien nou pa gen bon kretien ke yo pa pratike la parole.
During that time, the Christians were sharing their belongings. At that time, they were sharing the church. They were sharing with one another.
Yeah, at that time, longtemps l'église longtemps, yo kon partager sa rien avec l'autre.
And they wanted to be recognized as part of the church.
Yo te vle pou te konnen comme on partie dans l'église là.
So they sold some of their land.
Ou konn avec Ananias avec Sapphira.
To try to put on a good show and a good front.
Ananias avec Sapphira, yo te vend sa yo te gagne, puis yo te montre que t'a partagé tout à sa yo gagne, yo pote vin l'église là. Nous connais histoire très bien Ananias Sapphira, côté longtemps, côté tout nous partager tout ça yo gagne avec l'autre, mais Ananias avec Sapphira mette cœur non mauvais côté pas besoin connait Ananias Sapphira, yo te bail menti.
Bible says they held back part of the money.
Yo kembe on parti dans l'argent, yo va bail tout Ananias Sapphira, pas de bail comme la servante, yo te vle faire
and because of that, their dead corpses were carried out because they lied to the Holy Ghost.
Parce que by menti, yo te by set esprit bon Dieu menti, yo te tombé, yo te mouri parce que yo te by bon Dieu menti. Nous connais histoire dans cette figure. Parfois yo te besoin faire paraître tout, que c'est l'église qui besoin faire tout. Mais deep down, l'homme bien gardé au cœur pas avec sa affaire, mais cœur aussi dans la chambre. Côté cœur, côté trésor.
We see in the book of Joshua, chapter 7, verse 21, a man by the name of Achan. He says, when I saw among the goods, among the spoils, a goodly Babylonian garment, 200 shekels of silver and a wedge of gold, he says, I coveted them.
Yeah, li parle côté na bouche Josué, côté on monde te serré. Bagay sa, bagay trezo, bagay le monde sa, kote yo ta kwe detuit, men te kache yo, yo te sere yo.
Bible teaches us to beware of covetousness. Beware, be on guard against covetousness.
Realize kom kretien, ou suppose dwe onet.
It's still one of the commandments, thou shalt not covet thy neighbor's property.
Realize kou yon nan commandment yo bagwe vole.
How many knows that we live in a land that's full of covetous practices? You can pretty much go in any convenience store and buy scratch-off tickets. You don't have to go very far to walk into a big casino and lay your money on the table and gamble.
Pa bezwen ale lwen ou ka kote moun ap met lajan nan tab ki ap kembo. Tout sa ou bagay sa ou pa bon kretien pa ta dwe ap kembo, ap jwe gen sou ta, yo ka pa fè lajan.
There's horse racing betting. Dog racing betting. They bet on horses.
Ok. Li di ke nou wè kòman moun ap yo fè cheval, yo fè kous cheval, kom si yo ap mete lajan, yo fè kous cheval, ki cheval ki yon man, ki sa ka bien. Tan pou nou wè jwè ta nou konè kote yo ka fè wonder de Dieu kote a fè cheval pou yo comme chrétien bata dou a fè game sa bata dou a fè jouer sa ou pa bet sou cheval ki est ka gagne chrétien sa veut dire chrétien pa dou game pou pa dou jouer volé nou konnen sa très bien kote ka fè chegou chrétien bata dou fè bagay sa
they bet on who's going to win a football game who will win a basketball game
chrétien lè pendant je ta fè chrétien a dit ki moun ka gagne football la ki moun ka gagne basketball la gagne moun ki konnen ki konn mete à cause des jouets ça yo dit si un tel bagay yo kon mete kayo dit si un six un tel gen ma bo kay mwen gen ki kon perdi en pile fortune nan bagay gameplay nan bagay jouet que c'est pas que bagay ça yo
these things ought not to be my friends in the household of God
yo pa kwe fè la kay bon Dieu que c'est pas que a jouer hasard
Bible teaches us to love our neighbors we love ourselves
la Bible dit nous devons aimer
What kind of love does it show when I gamble with someone else and take their money that they worked hard for?
ou apprendre ka Elia si mon n'a perdu ou apprendre possession de sa guerre chrétien va dans le possession par l'autre monde. Il dit qui j'allais à mon ça, et ça veut dire jouer à ça pardon pour que c'est fait. Parce que les mondes petit cas comme chrétien, va t'adresser. Mais le monde l'apprend. Il dit que c'est pas de faire jouer ça.
There's no love in that, my friend.
Il dit pas gagner à mon ça, mon petit cas l'apprend. Mon petit bien l'apprend. Pas gagner à mon ça.
As Jesus is analyzing the churches in the book of Revelation, chapter 2 and chapter 3.
Il dit bon Dieu analyse l'église. Dans le livre Révélation, Apocalypse chapitre 2, chapitre 2, chapitre 3.
In Revelation chapter 2, verses 8 through 11, the church in Smyrna, he says, I know your works and your tribulation and your poverty, he says, but you are rich.
Dans Révélation, what is the chapter again?
That's chapter 2, verses 8 through 11.
Il y a dans Révélation chapitre 2, Apocalypse. Chapitre 2, verset 8 à 11.
Yeah. Yeah. He says, I know your poverty, but you're rich, he says. That's the way that God assessed this church. The world assessed them as poor and impoverished, but God saw them as rich.
Il dit dans l'église, ça, il était pauvre, mais bon Dieu, l'homme, le monde garde comme pauvre, mais bon Dieu garde son église qui était riche.
In Revelation chapter 3, verses 14 through 22. The Laodicean church.
Apocalypse 3, verset 14 à 21.
It says, during those verses, it says, because you say I am rich and increased with goods and have need of nothing, and you don't know that you're wretched, poor, miserable, blind and naked.
Mais quand elle te parlait avec l'église Laodicée, elle dit parce que tu es riche, vous avez un pile fortune, moi-même garde autant pour son monde qui sont l'église qui pauvre.
The Laodicean church was a church of monetary wealth. They had money. They saw themselves as rich. They saw themselves as prosperous. They saw themselves as having true riches. But God says, no, you're wretched, you're poor, you're miserable, you're blind, you're naked. I don't see you that way, he said.
You're not bragging. You're not saying, oh, no, you're riches, no, capable. Jésus dit même pas garder autant pour son église qui gagne richesse qui capable. On garde son église qui pauvre qui est nu. Pas même rad sou même.
I think of Mark chapter 12 where Jesus is assessing the people as they throw money into the treasury. They're giving to the kingdom of God. They're throwing money in. Rich people are coming that day. They're throwing in great amounts of money. And then this poor little widow woman comes in and she throws in 2 mites, the smallest coin of the day. Probably like 2 pennies, a very, very insignificant amount of money.
Il dit que dans Matthieu, côté nous connaît l'histoire, ça fait bien. Côté, il t'a fait offrande dans la caille pour Dieu dans l'église. Tout riche, monde riche, t'a baillé. Riche, corps, il t'a fait des corps dans l'offrande. T'es grand dame qui t'a baillé seulement 2. Donc, il a dit 2 pennies. Mais bon Dieu de considérer dame ça débaille plus parce qu'elle débaille tout ça qu'il gagne.
Some of them probably threw in hundreds and thousands of dollars that day.
Il dit qu'il y en a d'autres qui étaient capables de bailler 100 000 combien de quoi parce que y'a gagné l'argent, il y a pas eu fin.
But those 2 little coins, this poor little widow woman.
Il dit qu'il y a quand elle veut ça, c'est seulement qu'elle débaille 2 pennies.
He said she threw in more than all of them.
Jésus te considéré dame ça te bail plus que eux-mêmes parce que te bail tout ça te gagne.
Because they threw in out of their abundance.
Yo dis yo te bail, mais tu te bail pas en pile l'argent, mais au bien en pile le bail. Tu vas te bail tout ça au bien te gagne.
But she threw in out of her need.
Y a lui-même Jésus dit malgré qu'il y a le besoin, il te bail de ça.
I'm telling you this morning, God doesn't look upon things the way that most people do.
Dis il vient tout ça matin. Jésus pas regarder bagaille au même genre l'homme regarder. Le monde gagne, j'en gagne, j'en prospère. C'est pas que le monde gagne, j'en prospère, j'en gagne richesse. C'est pas comme ça Jésus gagne.
Maybe even the way that you've been assessing it.
Les gens, même j'en vois les gens assassinant, dans richesse, dans fortune, ou quoi, dans bien matériel, mais Jésus va gagner comme ça.
I'm telling you, God's looking in your heart this morning.
Matin, ami dit ça, Jésus vient gagner dans le cœur, il va venir gagner dans son possédé. Ça va intimider Jésus.
This is the first service of your
n'est pas venu garder dans le bien matériel qui sort pour céder.
The revival starts in the heart of man.
Il dit le veille que je dis après mes jours de vent, le veille a de commencer dans le cœur. C'est pas dans le processus, sort pour céder, prospérité. C'est pas ça que Jésus vient garder.
That Laodicean church. The Laodicean church in Revelation 3.
Il dit Jésus va garder dans le bagage.
They thought they were rich and increased with goods.
L'église là où disait tes quoi ont gagné l'argent.
Had need of nothing.
Jésus dit bah ça va bien. Il t'a gardé au monde qui était nu. L'église là où disait nous t'a gardé dans Apocalypse chapitre 3. Dit Dieu dit nous gagne bien, nous gagne richesse. Il dit Jésus va te garder dans bagage ça. Réveille-le par l'eau. Je dis à c'est dans cœur lié, c'est pas dans bien, c'est pas dans ce côté où on cherche là.
But God saw them as a lukewarm church.
Lukewarm,
he said, I wish you were hot or cold. Just barely hot. Lukewarm.
Yeah, I got it.
In other words, if you're hot, I can use you. But if you're cold,
You know,
we've been sold a bill of goods by the prosperity teachers. I think of how do you preach a message like that to someone like Joseph that's been imprisoned for a decade in the book of Genesis? How do you tell him about the prosperity message? If he had enough faith, he wouldn't be in the prison house. But he was in the prison house because of the word of God. What his brothers meant for evil, God meant it for good. He was putting Joseph in a strategic place for a strategic time in history because that's
Joseph de prospérité, au monde qui est dans la prison. Au monde frère Vanni, vous mettez la prison. Qui message prospérité au monde qui a vu prêcher Joseph pendant la prison? Mais il dit, mais malheur, ça qui est arrivé Joseph dans la prison, mais c'est pour demain pour être capable d'aider frère. Nous connaissons l'histoire de demain. Quand des frères Joseph ont vendu Joseph, Joseph devenu tombé dans la prison dans l'Égypte. Il dit, comment au monde qui a vu parler Joseph des bagages prospérité pendant Joseph? Et dans la conscience, il connaît la vie rien qui mal, il est tombé dans la prison. Qui message pour ce que dans mon sort, les propres Joseph comme exemple, qui message pour travailler Joseph pendant que la prison, parfois il y a un petit critique dans la prison, il va y avoir innocent, mais il est dans la prison.
How do you tell Paul the apostle he has no faith? A man that wrote us about half the New Testament.
Paul.
How do you tell Paul he's got no faith?
Comment on dit Paul, les bagages là?
He says, I know how to be obeyed and I know how to bow. Whatever state I find myself, I've learned to be content. I've learned to have met much and I've learned to suffer need.
Apôtre Paul dit lui-même, il connaît qui j'ai pour le vivre en abondant, il a vu gros, mais il connaît qui j'ai nous pour le vivre petit.
In other words, God took him at times into the deep wilderness and he took him on times up onto the high mountain, just like he'll take each one of us. The Bible says that Jesus in all points was tempted like we are, yet without sin. We're all going to go through the refiner's fire. We're all going to be tested to see if our faith is genuine.
Listen, même Jean, Jésus Satan était tenté Jésus, mais Jésus pas déjà péché. Listen, nous même comme chrétiens, c'est même Jean tout. Gagnez-nous des moments où nous montons, gagnez-nous des moments où nous descendons dans la vie.
Proverbs 23, 4 and 5, it says, labor not to be rich. Riches make themselves wings and fly away. Psalm 37:16, a little that a righteous man has is better than the riches of many wicked.
Psalm 37:16. Psalm 37, verses
37.
Yeah, Psalm 37,
16.
Verses says, mieux vaut le petit juste que l'abandon de beaucoup de méchants. Dis plutôt qu'on petit juste que grand pile méchant.
I want to tell you this morning,
even so,
in closing,
yeah, pour terminer,
Luke chapter 16 tells the whole story.
Luke chapter 16.
There was a rich man who lived sumptuously. He lived in elegance. He lived in
extravagance.
And there was a poor beggar man that sat at his gate. Looking to eat from the crumbs that fell from the rich man's table. And both the rich man and the poor beggar both died. And the beggar was carried to Abraham's bosom where he was comforted. He had no financial excellence in this world. Bank account was probably empty. Probably wasn't a homeowner. Didn't own a car. But he was carried to Abraham's bosom where he was comforted. And the rich man who had a nice house. And he had the finest food to eat. He had the nicest wardrobe. Best transportation of the day. Pockets were full of money.
Bible
said he found himself in torments. Looking at Abraham could come and just dip his finger and touch his tongue because he was tormented in the flame. I'm telling you, if you're a possessor of the Holy Spirit this morning, the Bible says you're a king and you're a priest. You're already royalty this morning. You're an heir with God and a joint heir of the Lord Jesus Christ. You're an ambassador for God and a minister of reconciliation. You're of great value and of great importance this morning.
Focus on
if we were all rich, how could we relate to the poor and the middle class? The Lord does what he wants with his servants. He puts them in strategic places at strategic times. He gives the power to gain wealth that his covenant might be made known. All we can do is whatever our hand finds to do, do with all the power that
trois, quatre jobs, si vous êtes tout, et pour perdre 10 relations ensemble avec mon Dieu, et pour saluer du matin, c'est focus sur la bagaille, mon Dieu, pas négliger le travail, mon Dieu.
If you're faithful over the little things, God can trust you with greater things.
Il dit, sous fidèle, l'anti bagaille, mon Dieu, à fond, mon Dieu, c'est un gros bagaille.
But if you can't even bring the tenth into the storehouse, that the church could continue to run, how could God trust you with greater things than that?
Il dit, sous baga paye 10% dans la dîme, que mon Dieu baga fort confiance dans payer la dîme. Comment mon Dieu baga fort confiance dans gros bagaille? Lorsque c'est chrétien, il faut supposer fidèle dans payer la dîme.
God is looking for us to show faithfulness that He might exalt us and use us for the furtherance of His kingdom.
Il dit, bon Dieu a regardé, bon Dieu a regardé pour la plus ou dans ces bagailles, pour qu'il y ait ce bagaille qui plus gros. Et bon Dieu voulait pour nous fidèles.
God wants you to be rich this morning.
Bon Dieu voulait pour les riches matin.
Rich towards Him.
Il dit pour les riches dans Jésus.
Rich in heaven.
Il dit pour riches dans bagaille pour dans ciel.
He wants your bank account to be overflowing in heaven.
Il dit pour bank account monter dans le ciel. C'est pas sous terre, c'est pas bagaille terrestre pour focus.
He's not so much concerned about the bank here on Main Street.
Il dit pour ça, il va pas concerné avec canal que gagne sous terre ça.
But he wants the bank account in heaven to be overflowing with wealth and prosperity.
Il dit il veut pour bank account que dans ciel là et monter en pile pour gagner pile. Poser focus dans bagaille céleste matin focus au chrétien c'est pas bagaille périché pour bagaille qui a passé bien matériel qui a passé mais matin chrétien doit focus dans bagaille en haut bagaille du feu bagaille.
That's true riches, my friend.
C'est vraiment richesse là, c'est richesse dans Jésus matin, zami.
God bless your revival.
Que bon Dieu bénisse pour ce bel réveil ça.
That they might lay up great treasure in heaven.
Et puis on capable focus sur pas sur bagaille terrestre, supposé sur bagaille céleste matin.
In the name of Jesus.
Dans le nom de Jésus.
Amen.
Amen.